Tully spills the mark. Down he comes to ground. Another chance for St Kilda's Stewart, who's in there. And umpire Crouch says, away from it, and we'll have a ball up.
24 and a half minutes of play gone in the final quarter, and the score's level pegging. 10-13 both sides. There's the tap going to steer. It's come down to Wayne Lucasen. He lines it up. Hooks it right round. I think it's out of play, it is. Out of play, and so the scores remain level as we're almost into the time on period. There's Minot contesting a knockout, getting a two. Chance here for St Kilda. They overrun the ball though. They're under a lot of pressure at the moment. Collingwood really applying the pressure now, have the ball in their scoring zone.
Would the VFL want a draw? I think they might. Another £100,000 gate would be good.
There's Thompson getting the ball to Gablik. Gablik into the open spaces, comes towards Putnam. Baldock comes in now, knocks the ball away. Clears it back towards the centre of the ground. Comes in here towards Larry Hill. He fumbles it. Picked up by Adamson. Back it goes to Hill. Caught with the ball. Loses it. Away goes Stewart. Gets the ball forward. Come up towards Hill. He takes the field on that. John Waters pays. Paisley took the mark. Back he goes. There's his kick. Bring the ball up towards Neil. He flies too early. Green claiming the mark. Stacks on the mill. Away go Collingwood. Get the ball towards Rose. He's in trouble. They're going in all directions. Players throwing everything they've got into the closing stages of this memorable grand final.
What a tension builder. What a magnificent finish to the 1966 season. There's the bounce of the ball. Morrow taps it down. A chance for Griffiths. Throws himself for the ball, but it's kicked away across the line by Adamson and out of bounds. Scores level, 10-13 apiece, into the time on period. Boundary umpire Kidd throws the ball in. Up high was Steer, down towards Baldock. Baldock shoots the ball high in the air, and they set themselves. Hayes again from behind, can't mark the ball. Hill comes in, is met stopped solidly. Here's a chance for Stewart. Picks up the ball, hand passes to Cooper. Towards Potter, and Potter marks play on, says the umpire, as the ball had hit the ground before Potter marked it, and there'll be another ball up closer to St Kilda's goal. Umpire Crouch bounces the ball, the score's level. Minot reaches up there. A chance for Potter. He has the ball. He's caught. A chance for Green. Green pops the goal, and it's bounced through the point for St Kilda, and the Saints have a one-point lead.
And we are 28 and a half minutes or 28 minutes into the final quarter. Can St Kilda win their first premiership?
Boyne kicks the ball in. Howell is there. A chance for Rose. Gets the ball away towards Hill. Hill towards Henderson. Henderson's caught. Morrow throwing himself in. And here's Stewart. Gets a right foot kick for St Kilda. Up towards Minot. And Minot holds the mark.
In the second semi-final, Minot kicked the goal almost from here, but this is a little bit further out, I think. There's the very worried Alan Jeans, coach of St Kilda.
Minot comes in, drop punts. It's a long one right up to the 10-yard square. Pace sets himself, so does Waters, and it's Kerry Waters who holds the mark. Has to play on quickly now with Collingwood down by a point. Chooses to go around the outer flank. Reed is in front. Behind there is Putnam. Putnam with the whole field in front of him. Kicks the ball forward to the half forward line. St Kilda under pressure. Murray marks!
What a magnificent defender this fellow Murray has been for St Kilda in this game and in the preliminary final.
Murray, there's the silence! And St Kilda have won their first premiership. And Alan Jeans is being mobbed down in front of the St Kilda coaching team.
Well, you can imagine the excitement here of the St Kilda players. After striving for 70 years, they won their first ever premiership, and now they are a belated bunch of players. Look at them there. There's Alan Jeans, the coach of the St Kilda side. Bobby Rose with him, coming up to congratulate him. They're the St Kilda players around their coach, Sarakowski, number 13, who was such a magnificent player for them. There's Alan Jeans, the St Kilda coach, being shared by his players. A magnificent moment, a memorable one for him, one he will not forget in his long association with football, to coach St Kilda to their first ever premiership.
and that number in the Saints come turning.
Certainly was a tremendous 4th of July celebration down at Moorabbin this year during that Fitzroy match, which the Saints won, and they repeated the dose against Collingwood in the second last round there in August. St Kilda fans are full of optimism that that lone 66 Premiership trophy will be joined by another next season. But that's in the future. Tonight's all about the past, and in case all you Collingwood fans think we're picking on you, the footy marathon continues shortly with that glorious black and white day in history 29 years ago.
You wouldn't know what to do with a small holding.
Marathon, and it's the turn of the runner in...